I am Donna Young, the National Event Supervisor for the Astronomy Event for Science Olympiad, and this presentation has been designed to give the coaches and teams that are preparing for the 2013 Astronomy Event an overview of the topics and the content and the resources to help them prepare for state, regional, state, and national competition. The focus for this year's event is stellar evolution and type 2 supernova events. I'm the lead educator for the Chandra Education and Public Outreach Office in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and the Chandra EPO Office has sponsored the astronomy event since the first year it became an event in 1999. This webinar will be posted on the Chandra website under the education menu. And also, at the American Association of Variable Star Observers website, I am also staff for AAVSO. They also help sponsor the astronomy event for Science Olympiad. And when you go to their website, they will have a link to this webinar. And also, they will have the PowerPoint presentation for this webinar. And last year, this current year's event, 2012 year's competition for both astronomy and Reach for the Stars are posted on that website also for you to download and use as a practice test to study for the 2013 competition. So the event description for astronomy for 2013 is that the students need to have a basic knowledge of the physics and mathematics related to stellar evolution and type 2 supernova events. It requires a two-person team. The event usually takes about 50 to 55 minutes, and the team can bring either two laptops or two three-ring binders, or one laptop in one three-ring binder. The material inside the binder has to be in the three-ring binder itself. It can be any type of information from any source that you want. It just has to be bound. There's no size limit to the binder, and I have seen binders that are like this, but sometimes I think you can have too big of a binder, as well as you can have too much information stored on your computer. Remember, you only have 50 minutes to do the event, so you need to be very knowledgeable about the organization of your material so you can easily look up anything that you need to know to help you answer any of these questions. You should bring a programmable calculator. There will be, you need a scientific programmable calculator to answer the more difficult mathematical questions. And no internet access is allowed. So this year, the topics are all related to stellar evolutionary sequences that end up with a type 2 supernova event. Things like Cepheid variable stars, irregular variable stars, red supergiants, pulsars, neutron stars, black holes, and the actual supernova event itself. We have, again, every year there are 16 new deep sky objects, and those deep sky objects are all related to type 2 stellar evolutionary sequences. Last year, for those of you that did this event last year, or I say last year, 2012, it was actually this year in Orlando, the 2012 event. For those of you that prepared for that event. Last year's topic was stellar evolution and type 1a supernova events. So we were only concerned pretty much with this one line of stellar evolution from sun-sized stars through type 1a supernova events. For this year, this year's preparation for the 2013 event, we are now interested in these two stages of stellar evolution, starting with protostars, more massive stars than the sun, and they have a sequence that takes them through super red giants, they collapse into type 2 supernova events, and they leave behind neutron stars, some flavor of a neutron star, such as a magnetar or a pulsar or a black hole. There are more exotic events where stars can collapse into a black hole without leaving a supernova remnant, or stars can literally destroy themselves and leave no stellar core behind whatsoever. But we are more concerned in 2013 with these two lines of stellar evolution. It's sort of like this is, there is a, the Federation has a boundary, and on the other side of the boundary of the Federation, there'd be Klingons and Cardassians and Romulans and Borg. So we do not want to go there. So you only need to concern yourself with type 2 supernova events and the stellar cores that are left behind. This year's deep sky objects, there are three that are star formation complexes. There are five that are stars. One of them is a Cepheid variable star. Three of them are red supergiants. And the fifth one is a Wolf-Rayet star. There are six different types of type 2 supernova remnants. Well, five of them are supernovas with the stellar cores. One of them is only a stellar core without a remnant. And there are two X-ray binaries. X-ray binaries are a binary system that consists of a stellar mass black hole with a companion star. So, stellar nurseries, star formation areas. One of the star formation areas this year is the Rho Ophiuchi cloud complex. When you look at star formation areas, they all have three things. They have three different types of nebulae that you see in them. There is usually a blue area, which is a reflection nebula, where you have massive stars radiating energy at very high frequencies, and that light is preferentially scattered in the blue, so they show up as a blue, because they're reflecting radiation from stars that are hidden inside the gas and dust. There are red ones, and that's where stars are actually ionizing the gas and dust around them, mostly hydrogen 2 areas, and so the gas and dust material itself is radiating, emitting energy that we see in the red, because that is the color associated with hydrogen emissions in the visible part of the spectrum. And then you will see these dark clouds, very black clouds. Those are just more dense areas of gas and dust that don't allow the reflection or emission radiation to get through and reach us, so they just appear very dark. And another thing to pay attention to when you're studying the deep sky objects and these images is do not learn the deep sky objects in one orientation, because once we get away from the artificial construct of terrestrial coordinates, and you get out there in the big, big universe, there's no up, there's no down, there's no east, and there's no west. So if I could, I can invert this vertically, I can invert it horizontally, and everything appears in a different area. So, and this could be taken by optical, this could be an optical image, it could be an X-ray image, it could be an infrared image, it could be a superimposement of all of those three different types of images. So be sure that you look at enough images of each deep sky object that you're familiar with it in a multiplicity of wavelengths and orientations. This will show up later because this is actually Antares Alpha Scorpii, which is one of the stars this year in the deep sky object